Dinell with My Christian Films, and we are here in Kissimmee, Florida at the Freedom Life Church for the Love Can Tour. We're going to catch up and sit down with December Radio, get to know who they are, where they're going, and what's coming up next. Let's go on inside.
Hey,
we're December Radio,
and this is MyChristianFilms.org.
The bright lights and late nights, the devil took me on a midnight ride. Lift me out in the desert on my own.
If you don't mind introducing each of you, give your names and who you are and where you're from.
My name is Eric and I play guitar and I am from Virginia.
I'm Boone, I play drums from Tennessee.
I'm Josh, I'm from Virginia. I play bass and sing.
I'm Brian, I'm also from Virginia, and I play guitar and do backup vocals.
Awesome. So I understand that it kind of started with the two of you when you guys got together. So how did that happen?
Well, Brian and I started taking guitar and started playing guitar around the same time. And we just started playing together, started taking from the same guitar teacher. And that led to us forming our first little band, and his twin brother was in the band as well. And we started just playing locally at different churches and just different things, and felt God calling us to do what we do now.
Started early on collaborating with an evangelist, his name's Billy Wayne Arrington?
Yeah.
Arrington. Billy Wayne. Now, what did working with him, or even being mentored, I guess, under him, what did that do for the course of your band?
It was definitely a discipleship. We were able to kind of see where God was really wanting to work on us in our own lives, and I realized that, you know, the music could not be my God, and it satisfied me. I had to lay that down and say, God, this is yours, and whatever you want me to do, I'll do. And so it was really great being able to become rooted in our faith and just grow deeper with our walks with Billy. So it's been awesome. We owe him a great deal, and God used him in our lives.
Awesome, because that's what God does. He really puts people in our pathway to keep us on the right path that we're supposed to go.
He definitely would keep us on the right path.
Was he that kind?
Yeah, he would. Yeah, that's right. He would beat
Still
it
is.
Into us.
Yeah.
Well, hey, that's good. It gives you a strong foundation. You guys came out. You had a couple of albums prior to signing with your label. How did that make you feel when the very first album you released with your label gets nominated for a Grammy Award? What does that do? Because, mind you, again, this goes back to that same question. You've been giving it up and said, okay, Lord, here you go. It's all good. We're just going to do it for you. And then you're nominated for a Grammy. A Grammy. This is mainstream here.
I think immediate disbelief.
Yeah. We were like, you are lying. when we got the phone call, I was like, you're kidding me, right?
Brian and I were in a pawn shop together, weren't we? And we're like, we gotta get on the internet this evening.
But it was cool. It was an honor, and we had a great experience. We went out to LA and got to walk the red carpet, and we're just thankful for it. That God bless us with that opportunity. And it's nice because even though you do sing for an audience of one, it's still good to have the approval of your peers and things. So
absolutely,
it's a great thing.
Absolutely, and that approval got you a Dove Award this year. For Rock Album of the Year, right?
That's right. The last two albums.
The
first one.
Yeah. Okay. We're two for two.
No pressure.
No pressure.
No pressure at all. What has it been like? Who writes your songs? Is it one particular person? Is it a collaboration?
Yeah, we collaborate.
Yeah.
Brian and I do most of the main writing, and then we'll bring it in and we'll tweak things and work on it as a group, and we want to make the song the best it can be, and it's all about the song. It's all about what that song is going to say, that message that it's trying to speak, because a song has a life of its own.
You guys have been on a path for the last 2 years of just constant touring, but with amazing music artists. I mean, you guys have toured with Newsboys and
Third Day,
and I mean, you just, what is that like? Because you're still considered a fairly new band. What is it like to be able to collaborate with some of the bigger names in this industry? And what have they inputted into your lives as influence and guidance?
It's definitely a dream come true. I know, especially the Third Day thing, Eric over here. Eric, we met Eric when he was playing in his church worship band. They were called Twist of Faith. And Eric, we saw him, and he had
it. Didn't know our name. We had it written right on our shirts.
Yeah, they had like soccer jerseys. They were purple, and they said Twist of Faith on them. And Eric had a headset mic on. And I was like, what is going on here? Actually, I'll have to say, I used a headset mic at one point in our career. Way back in the day.
He had to have his hands free for dancing.
But Eric's up there, and they're playing Third Day songs. So, you know, and of course, ended up Eric joined us, and then, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 years later, we're opening for Third Day. And it's just cool to see those guys and what they do day in and day out. And, how similar it is to what we do, but how they've endured through the years and been able to keep what they have together and keep it fresh and to still make a difference.
And now you're the headliner of the Love Can Tour that we're on right now. So we've kind of shifted. How's that feel? Is it a bit different?
It's good, yeah. It's different. When you're on a bigger tour, a lot of times you will get bigger audiences, but you only get to play for 20, 30 minutes. And then a set like this, though, it's cool because we get to do a full hour and a half set. And so, yeah, we like both of them, you know. It's kind of like life. You got to have a lot of balance, you know. So.
Balance. Yawning in the background. So, yes. It's okay because you guys have been traveling a lot. So who has families and how are you balancing families?
They didn't answer that for us since you're the newly married man.
We're all married now. Uh-huh. I got married 3 weeks ago.
Oh, congratulations.
Got married and took a 3-day honeymoon and came home and hit the road. But that's been the story of our life. It's all the guys, that's what we do. And having a wife that supports that and as much as involved in this ministry, you know, the calling in our lives that God has brought us through, they're just as much a part of that as we are. We can't do it without them. And they have to support us. It's hard. It's hard leaving them. You don't want to, but this is the calling God put in our life. And we'll support that. It takes a special woman, I assure you of that.
I would imagine so. Yeah. I would imagine
not
so.
Not too many wives say, yeah, go ahead and take a couple days and leave. Catch
you
when
you come back. No kids yet? Nobody has kids yet?
I'm going to have one on the way. In about 7 months. So
okay.
I'll be the first.
New addition.
That's what happens with bands, you see. Like, one guy does it. Yeah, got one on order. I got a bun in the oven.
Brian's last name is Bun.
There you go.
But with bands, when one guy does everything, everybody kind of follows. So it's Josh is the first to get married, then we all follow. So now we'll probably all start having kids.
What's next for December?
We're going on tour with a band called Seventh Day Slumber. Yeah, and then, you know, summer comes and we'll hit a lot of the festivals and things like that.
Second part of spring, we're going to support our new live DVD and CD.
Yeah.
Live CD that we have at the store that we just recorded. So we'll be doing that for some of your live tours before the end of the
season. Awesome. What would you say to up-and-coming bands who are watching and looking at you and seeing your stories and going, I know that that's what I'm supposed to do or that's what I want to do? What words of encouragement can you give them?
I think the lessons that we continually learn are you have to be faithful in the small things, you know, grow where God's planted you. Perseverance is a big one. It's a long road, and you have to enjoy the journey. You know, it's not just about that final destination, so just enjoy what you're doing. And just, it's a lot of hard work, but it's worth it, and it's a blessing.
You get caught up in your future. You know, I was trying to plan it, but, you know, we all know God's the one planning that. Sometimes our plans are not his plans. So we gotta let him take control and remain in control.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for being here. Well, awesome, guys. Thank you so much for some of your time out there. I look forward to seeing you in action.
Yeah. All right.